Can you tell me how you met with yourself?
Mrs. Simpson, I'm not quite sure I understand.
You are willing to sacrifice children's lives in order to protect an informant. And what are they even informing on anyway? Some deported unionists who haven't done anyone any harm. That captain and the gang he works for are doing people harm.
You're clearly a smart woman, Mrs. Simpson, so I won't do you the disservice of pretending that I don't understand what you're talking about. I'll merely say this. There's a greater good in ensuring the peaceful transition of the Reach. Unfortunately, there will be some casualties along the way.
Yes, a child is dead.
And what would you have me do?
Give up the captain so the police can arrest the gang and put an end to this miserable trade.
We all make moral choices, Mrs. Simpson. And sometimes we set out with the best of possible intentions and end up making more difficult decisions than we desired.
What could possibly be difficult about deciding who lives and who dies? The children and the captain...
What could be more difficult than deciding to be faithful to your husband? You expose me, I'll expose you.
I have no idea what you're talking about.
Of course. And I have no idea what you're talking about. Good evening, Mrs. Simpson.
I gave you 20,000 men.
They're very tired, Johnny. Hasn't been an easy day, but as you can imagine, and so very hot.
We English hold three colonies in India. Imagine if we could link them up.
To many others in this room, building an empire in India is not the policy of His Majesty's government.
Damn hot, isn't it? Yeah. Never felt such heat since the bloody Saddam.
Nanjing is close to the press. It's past the Japs. It's their court, not ours.
Barnes. This is my good friend, Andy...
Fisher.
Terrific fellow. He's here to see his girl. I'm George Hall.
Hi, Daisy. Meet Roger Rabson. I'm grateful shit from the British Embassy.
Mr. Fisher and I have already met. That's his girl?
He's marrying her on Tuesday.
He won't be here on Tuesday. He's headed straight for hell himself in the morning.
Maybe we should do something about their slippery ladders. It's very painful.
D.H. Lawrence's classic masterpiece is now a major motion picture.
Clifford.
You could tell me it's all untrue.
Go ahead. Take a man if you wish, only never leave me.
A man, Connie. Not a damned...
peasant? Slave?
What if you got pregnant, my lady? Think of that. Think of me. Think of the future. I thought of who it might be, but that damned Oliver Mellors.
Oliver?
You never even asked his name.
Could I trouble you for a night? Thank you.
So
Dilly's dead tonight, isn't it? Been here an hour now, not a thing. Except two policemen disguised as human beings. Well, you're not going to be much good to me now, are you?
No.
I will. C'est la vie, I suppose. Shall we have a cup of coffee?
Yes.
I learned that I was not the only one in the world.
Dorian, I want to understand. I want to be able to defend you, but I can't look into your soul. Would you like to? What? See my soul. After all, why not? You've had more to do with the matter than anyone. You've a right to see the result.
What do you mean?
Merely that I keep a diary of my life from day to day. A different kind of diary. It never leaves the room in which it's written. Come. I'll show it to you.
Je m'appelle Pierre Valmont. Un petit conseil. Si vous voulez la sexe la nuit, l'achèterez un McDivas hamburger tout de suite. C'est très simple.